Hey, what is going on, guys? It is Spot the Aussie here with round 10 of the Motorsport Manager Season 2 Championship with Dragon Team China Racing with Alice Wood and Ahmed Dalmatov. And at the moment, we are currently first and third in the championship. I have stacked third place's car, Alice Wood, this round and this round only with the better components of the car. So the gearbox, the engine, the front wing, the rear wing are all stacked to have Alice's car more superior to our championship leader Ahmed, and that is because Ahmed's in a very safe position at the moment. He is 16 points clear of second place. Let's just have a look and confirm that for us. He's only 9 points clear of Tyler, but 17 points clear of Wood. Now my thinking here is if I can get Wood to come first or much higher than Tyler, we could possibly jump Tyler to come first and second in the championship. Currently, we are ripping up in the team championship with 29 points advantage coming at the end of the season. We are in a really good window. And as you can see with the setup for both cars, Alice Wood, I've been able to get the handling. Let's have a more particular look. I've been able to get the downforce, handling, and speed. Excellent, excellent, great. I was able to tweak them and fine-tune for quite in that window where we could get the cars running at their optimum range. As for tyre choice, we are going to softs. Fuel options, I'm going to go 6 because I want Wood to do an extra lap. I want Wood to get that extra lap of clean air while everyone else pits. And as for the strategy, I am going to say normal fuel burn, but attack mode, purely because the tyres will last longer than the fuel in our car and the way it's set up. For Ahmed, similar story, excellent, excellent, excellent. Car is optimum. No changes to be made. Only going to be doing 5 laps, starting fuel. Our objective this round is coming at a tight first place, so we do not get our $1.2 million pound bonus unless we come first. Now, I don't know about you guys, but at the moment, it has been a bit of an up and down championship. Do you think this gamble was the right way to go? I'm going to pose that question to you by stacking Wood's car with the better components. And more importantly, before we start this race, do you think Wood is going to come out ahead of Ahmed by the end of this race? Let me know in the comments section below. And also, let me know what you think so far of the videos. Do you like how loud the sound is, the background sound, the cars, the microphone? Do you want the face cam to be bigger? Do you want it to be positioned in a different corner? You know, all that feedback has been able to help me develop a better product for you guys to watch. So we are going to be rolling straight into this race. We might flick it into fast forward mode just for the first little bit while they all sort themselves out. And we're currently at a very stalemate kind of a move, with Wood and Dalmatov actually coming in last and second last by quite a bit. But as you can see, we catch right back up to the field because they are in their own little battle pack. With those reverse grids, what you'll always find is one car will always get ahead, but then they'll be held up randomly by other cars. Dalmatov makes a move onto Strambi and he's calling over the radio. That felt good. So what you can see here is there will be like one or two cars at the front holding up the rest of the field. For example, an Evans is like the worst driver in our field, so everyone will get behind him and no one else will be able to advance while he drives really defensively, and that will back the battle pack up with us. But what's happening at the meantime is the front runners are getting away, and we see this race and race again because that's what always happens with reverse grids. The fastest cars are at the back while the not so great cars are at the front, and people are able to skip away because of that. And the gap already back to Rogers is 3 seconds and 1 second to Valdez, and then it's just a split down all the way as our good friend Evans. Where is he? Is he still there? I'm probably looking straight at him, I just can't see him. Evans dropping into 12th spot. Now, you just want to get by him because he is going to be holding up the field like no one's business. It's kind of like his own safety car. Quite frustrating. Here we go. Can Dalmatov gets through? He gets through already. He's up in a 14th position. Evan back in 15th, who we were just looking at before. And currently on the move. This is quite surprising. Since we've given the worst car to Dalmatov, he is the better driver than Wood statistically. But he's able to make a bit more of a progress up the field. And that's probably because one of his main traits is overtaking. And he's, well, Wood is currently screaming that she's making passes through the field. Evans already slipped down to 18th, going to be holding up John Stoddart and Costa. Where is Tyler? Tyler is one step ahead of us. So the person who we are aiming to beat is Tyler. So some of our strategy might play around her just a tiny little bit to see what she's doing, and then we may or may not follow. As you can see, the majority of the field pits, and we're going to move into 6th and 7th position, tightly following onto Tyler. Now, we're not losing much out, despite them having the best car on the grid, and that's where we want to be. We want to be able to do an extra lap. It looks like Delatov is... Oh, I've got his engine mode mixed up, and he might actually run out of fuel if we're not safe. So I'm going to put him back down to low, and the idea here is to pit him this lap. Currently in 6th, I'm surprised he was able to make so many moves, given that that was his position. So we're going to go to fuel, add the full 6 laps, because we only want to do one more stop after this. Parts look good, strategy fast, tyres new sauce. And away he goes, conservative move all the way to the pits, because he only has 1.6 laps of fuel. Will he make it around before coughing? I hope so, because we don't want to lose out at all here. And will he? Will he? Yep. So that's good. He just makes that window. Meanwhile, we can start punching Wood to do some faster times by pushing out on those on the engine mode by revving it up to overtake mode. While the tyres, we might sit on the tyres a little bit because they're already down to 36%. We've chewed them up a little bit. The stop was bad for Ahmed. We're going to put him back on a medium strategy and use up the tyres as much as he possibly can. Let's look at that tyre range. She is currently running at a very high tyre temp, so it's going to chew the tyres a little bit faster. I am going to put them back into conservative mode, and I am going to go one more lap. I just want to see what the lap times are. She did a 1:30 last lap, and that's faster than the majority of the field, so I'm going to put her out for one more lap. Hopefully we're able to get that 5%, or do I want to come in early? Last minute call. No, we're going to do that one more lap. I think she can do it. I think she can get 4 to 5%. 3% might have been a bit of a wrong move there, but that's okay. We'll live with it. Fuel is currently low as well, so we're going to go back to medium. We might even go to conservative in the second half of that lap. We're going to put tyres on a backup mode while we dribble around that 26%. Delatov makes a move into 8th position, going around the outside of Mello, makes it stick. Thank you very much for coming. Still has a lot of fuel. Let's watch Wood. We want to really watch what Wood's doing in terms of fuel. We're going to put her down to low and drive ourselves as conservative while we just nurse the car back into the pits. She shall have enough fuel, 0.2, 0.1. That's exactly what Delatov was when he was rolling around. Now, given that they are very low on fuel... Ooh, forgot to almost hit the pits. That would have been really, really bad. Let's go to 6 laps. Let's try and push your car so we put you in a good window at the end of the race. Are you kidding me? What just happened? Oh my god. I could have sworn there would have been enough time to be able to pull in, but that has not happened, and now Wood is going to go around another time with low fuel and 0.2 tyre percentage. This is going to be terrible. Will she hold up the rest of the field? Yes, she will. I wouldn't be surprised if she does not make it around back to the pits. Going to that reserve tank pretty much. How is Delatov going with his fuel? He is going okay at this stage. I might just put him back down to push. Sitting in 7th, fighting his way through. Hopefully he can get by without being held up too much by Wood, who's currently holding up the field. Yeah, make it stick. Wood is going to hold up, cause a little bit of a buffer back. Can we push Wood? Dude, this is a last stop. Maybe we can make this work. Oh, I can't believe that. 6 laps of fuel. It will be not enough laps to get around. Let's go push in attack mode straight out of the box. That is going to be a terrible stop for us. Where is Tyler? Tyler was coming fifth. This decision is probably going to come back to bite us. It's a little unfortunate. Delatov drops from fourth into fifth. 6, Wood complaining over the radio about the slow stop. How about the fact that I missed the pits for her and she is going to be filthy all the way back in 15? I think we may have cost ourselves the race. That was our prime number one car. Unfortunately, just remember, you want to get your pit communication in earlier than what I just did. And at the moment, it looks like Rogers has gone to the pit. Delta now has a bit of space. Let's see what his tyre range is. Let's get him into neutral, but high on the engine mode. We can suck up a bit more fuel while he pushes for an extra lap. Wood is going to be using up both tyres and engine mode just to get around. Hopefully she can make a couple more spots and it doesn't detour our championship too much. But Tyler is currently in the lead, and that is the last person we want to see at the front of the track. But that's the way it crumbles sometimes, and it is going to be lap 10 when they come back around. Delatov, let's put you back into a medium mode. I cannot believe I have stuffed that up. Delatov currently setting his fastest time, as you can see by that little sector box. It is the fastest sector for sector 1. Sector 2 is not his fastest time, but it might be his fastest lap overall if he can just make it around. And this will be his last lap before going in pit. So let's make sure we get his stop right. Pits, new tyres, condition, good, fuel. 5 laps will remain. And we are going to be in a good window. The fact that Tyler has to go in 1 lap early means her tyres will not be as great as ours. Wood fighting back from 12th. Can we get in the top 10 with Wood? I hope so. That is our quest for this race. Just going to be pushing the car to its limits. She has been able to get past Van Aden. El Sadat goes to pit, so she moves up into 11th. Delatov, how are we going with you at the moment, mate? Let's push you into a high mode. As for the tyres, neutral, sit there because they are about to rub down below that 25% threshold, so put him into conserve. He will pit, and where is Tyler? How long? It's a 20. It's a little bit more than a 20-second gap back to Tyler, and Tyler might get pulled up by Gerard, hopefully. He is hoping that happens to some degree, while we resort and reshuffle ourselves back into the order from that dreadful stop strategy that we've had so far. Wood fighting to get in that top 10 spot. She comes underneath Rogers and she makes it, so goes around the outside. It's a good move, but Alex, late brakes. Excessively late brakes. How is the pit stop going? Delatov gets a good stop. He comes out in third position. So we are in a really good competitive position here. Because we have good tyres and fuel, both are going to be an overtake. And driving is on attack mode, engine mode is in attack mode. Wood will get this last lap in. So we are going to have to pit for Wood right now. Go to softs again. Park condition looking all good. 4 laps. Let's just put it to 4. Strategy fast. And in you go. So Ahmed currently in third, fighting to get in that first spot. Unfortunately, he does not have the prime car, like I've said throughout the start of this video. We have given it to Wood to try and benefit her. Now, I believe we can fight for first position from here. We just need to get past Shah, who's holding us up. There is a bit of a boot. They go around the outside. There was a couple of touches there, but he makes it stick. Shuffling Shah out of the way, and now he's going to be chasing Senna Anna for the race win. He still has excess fuel. The tyres, temps are coming on, so we're going to switch that to high driving style. Engine mode is going to be on high mode as well. Alice drops the 40th, sitting in the pits. Both were good on the stop out. So she has excess fuel and tyres, again, going in that overtake aggressive mode. Currently sitting behind Valdez, and Chifoy should be a little bit further up the road. We're going to be trying to fight to get in the top 10, so this last race of the championship, she can try to come back into second spot. I'm hoping something happens to Tyler in the next couple of laps. I don't think that's going to be possible. Tyler actually moving up in the third spot as we speak. Delatov moving into first position, setting his first sector of that lap. And because of that, we are going to put him into attack mode for both, just so he can try and get the fastest lap to slap. If it does not come off, I'm going to pull him off that aggressive strategy. In fact, I might just let it keep running while he's just sitting all the way out front there. Wood now fighting for 14th and 3rd. Moves 3rd under, brakes. Antonov goes around the outside, gets the better exit. Cannot make it stick at all. Nothing seems to be working at the moment. Fuck, man, he does his first, fastest first sector, fastest second sector. Fastest lap, actually. This is going to be the fastest lap. Purple represents fastest lap of the race. Let's see if he can make it stick. Yes, he does. He goes the fastest on the track. He actually sets a 127, and no one seems to be clear near that at all, except for Tyler doing 128. So let's just keep pushing while we make it work. I might drop back to conservative mode for the final lap. Wood's still fighting for that spot. Let's drop you to high mode. As for the tyres, let's put you to neutral. Push mode, actually. So what's the gap difference? 12 positions is going to be 12 points. Oh, it looks like there's a bit of a carry-on here. Can Wood benefit from that? And while Dalton's time goes down, let's put him back into low. To neutral for tyres. Tyler having mechanical issues. Hopefully something happens there. Wood now up to 13th. Let's follow Wood around because it seems like Delatov is in a really safe spot. I put him on a very conservative strategy just to finish off. There's no need to keep pushing. He has already set the fastest lap. As for Wood, I need you to keep fighting. I need you to try and get up there. One more spot. Three more spots possibly with all these back markers getting in your way. He moves up into 12th spot, goes underneath. A mistake by Valdez. Moves up into 10th by another mechanical issue for Costa. Can she move into 9th, being currently held up by Shah? Go around the outside, do something. Come on, make it happen, make it happen. Meanwhile, Dalatov comfortably comes around and is going to be in that lead by 4 seconds and will finish that race. Wood goes up in a 9th spot. Still chasing Rogers now. Goes down the inside after going on the slipstream. Currently in 8th. Can she chase down 7th? This isn't going to be that bad. Excess fuel, go to attack, go to push mode. Tires back to push on that 25% mark. And Wood is actually going to end up with a respective 8th position. So I'm not displeased about that. It could have gone a lot better. Only 6 positions behind Tyler. So 6 points down on Tyler. Now that would make it almost impossible for her to win or to come second in the championship. That's alright. Meanwhile, how did Tyler finish? Was Tyler struggling in that last lap? No, she was going faster than us, actually. So, look, good way to finish the race. Unfortunately, a bit of a bad situation for us. Hopefully, there's one or two cars use the legal components and they get pushed back in this pack. That would be great for us, bad for them. But even if we can get one or two more spots, get those extra one or two points up to Tyler, then it won't be that bad of a round for us. Let's have a look. Fastest lap timing. Will we get it? A 127. Which is a great result for us. Let's just go straight. Yes, we do get the bonus. Checking cars. We don't use any illegal components. We are a very ethical team. Valdez gets dropped. Valdez gets dropped. How many spots? He got dropped 6 positions. So Wood moves up to 7th. Only 5 spots behind Taylor. Anna gets an illegal component as well, but potentially why she moved away. And why does it say that we were off target for the bonus? I don't know why it says that. Does that mean first overall for the round? I would think it meant first for the race, right? Let's have a look. You came first. So we should still get that bonus. Relationship with the mechanics goes up. As you can see, the driver's stats moves up for Ahmed very slowly. But as for Alice, nothing moves because she has reached her full potential, where Ahmed still has that one start to go. And let's have a look at our payday. 1.3 million sponsorship payments. We are just racking up for next season's car. This is going to be great for us. Thanks for tuning in, guys. It's been Spot the Aussie Round 10. I'll be doing another back-to-back video for the final round. Please make sure you check in. It should be a nail-biter. I'll make sure that I'm on my A-game to make sure we get both cars in a 1-2. It will be a great result if we can finish in a 1-2. I don't think we've done it yet, but we're going to do it next race. Can't guarantee it, but check it out, and hopefully we do, and I will see you guys next time. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and keep tuning in for new episodes every day.